Hello friends, I'm Neeru Saxena. I'm going to discuss about the construct of algorithm. Now there are three constructs of an algorithm on by which we can be able to develop the step-by-step execution of a program. So what are those constructs? One is sequence, selection and iteration. Now what is sequence? Sequence, as we know, that each and every step has to be followed one after the other. And these action or event leads to the next ordered action in a predetermined order. That means we are not going to skip any of the steps in between. Now, it cannot contain any number of action. It can contain any number of action, but no action can be skipped in the sequence. The program, when run, must perform each action in order with no possibility of skipping an action or branching off to another action. That is what we call as the sequence. Now, I'll explain it with the help of example. Now we are going to calculate the average of two numbers. This is the logic for making the average of two numbers. To solve or taking the average of two numbers, we require two numbers. So for that purpose, first of all, we have to ask or input two numbers. These two numbers has to be added up. Then divide the result by two because there are two numbers, and the result of the step two, that means the division, it is going to return the average of these two numbers. Now, over here, we had observed that by writing three steps, we are not going to skip any of the steps. That means we have to add two numbers, we have to divide these two numbers by two, and then calculating the average by dividing this number, and that the particular result is going to be returned, and that returning value is the average of two numbers. Second is selection. Now, what is selection? Whenever there is a question to be asked, depending upon the answer, the program take one particular course of action, after which the program move to the next event. That means whether the first block is going to be executed or the second block is going to be executed, that is known as the selection. This structure is sometimes referred to as if-then-else because it directs the program to perform the way if condition A is true, then perform action X, else perform action Y. Now again, we are going to discuss this selection with the help of one example. I'm going to print letter grade. Now, to print a letter grade, we require certain number. We are going to input that number. If number is between 90 and 100, then the set A is, or grade A is printed. Otherwise, if the number is between 80 to 89, then the grade B is going to be printed. In this manner, we are going to give the grades on the basis of that particular number. So we are going to observe over here that In the entire sequence of instruction, only one part is going to be executed. If the number is either between 90 to 100, or it will be between 80 to 89. If the range is from 90 to 100, then only A is going to be printed. The second step is going to be skipped. If the number is between 80 to 89, then the first block is going to be skipped. That means we had observed that based on a particular number, only one block is going to be executed. That is known as selection. Now, third is iteration. Iteration means repeating the particular process n number of times. This process wherein a set of instruction or structure are going to be repeated in a sequence for a specific number of time, that is known as the iteration or looping. When the first set of instruction is executed again, it is called iteration. When a sequence of instruction is as executed in a repeated manner, it is also known as the looping. repeating a particular thing n number of times that n is definite or finite. Again, I am going to take or explain with the help of example. I am going to find out the largest. How to find out the largest? That means we have to compare the number n number of time till the time the condition is satisfied. I require a list of positive integer where I have to find it out that which number is the positive integer. For that purpose, we require a number that we require a variable. That variable I declared is as largest, and the initial value of the largest variable is set to 0. We are going to ask more numbers. If integer is more than the largest, that means whatever the number I had allocated over here, set the largest, then set the largest to the value of that integer. That means if I enter 2, then enter 4, then I had entered 6, then I entered 3, then I had entered 5, then that means more integer I am going to ask till the number of time n integer, that means I am asking for 10 integer, then the comparison if the number is greater than the largest. Say if I am getting 5 or I am getting 10, and which is the largest most number, then I am going to set this largest value from 0 to 10. And then in that manner, my loop is going to be ended up, and I am going to return the largest, that means the maximum value I had obtained from this logic, that will be returned. So in this manner, I find it out that how I am going to make my program by using sequence, selection or iteration. So these three are referred as the construct of an algorithm. Thank you.